About how do we have no casualties in a
that's
war?
That's the goal, he's saying. Apparently.
Yeah, exactly. He's gone from A to Z.
What world do you have a war where there's no casualties?
He has gone from A to Z without explaining how you get there. The bottom line is he can't say it to the American public, but I think what he is saying, he is talking about what the future looks like and has not discussed the fact that we're going to be there for a long period of time. You can't be in a country and have no casualties unless you are.
Let me give you an example.
Peace.
Excuse me. He always talks.
Satan, as long as Satan knows what
he's
doing.
Okay, that's a strong position, well, Michelle. Are you that tough?
I wouldn't want him to hire Lucifer to work for him, but you know, whether it's the Obama campaign or McCain's got Charlie Black. You are not going to hire anyone who has any sense of how Washington works or how our government
veterans.
Works. You can't hire anyone in this town that actually knows what they're doing unless they've got some job experience, and inevitably you're going to run into conflicts of interest. I think this was silly, but that being said, the whole story was going to become about Jim Johnson, so he didn't really have
a
choice.
Well, wait, are the Saints going to come bar so high he can't fill a cabinet? He can't put a cabinet together now. He can't use anybody from Washington, anybody's ever lobbied, anybody's ever had a nick on them. That's a pretty good standard. Is it going to work?
He's going to have to name some people who know their way around Washington, and he will. And there'll be some criticism, but frankly, I think it'll work out fine. The real problem for Barack Obama, the good side, I think, was how quickly the campaign dealt with this. The bad thing was that lousy answer. The initial response of Barack Obama
You're
was
right.
to say, well, he doesn't work for me. What is that? No one,
that was
no
weak.
One could look. He looked like Chauncey Gardner in the Gardner in being there. And what you need, the Democratic parties need, like Neo in The Matrix. He's the one. You don't need Chauncey Gardner, who's clueless.
I know he was clueless.
Neo was a scary dude. I don't think he needs Neo.
this whole question of it was a very bad answer by Barack Obama the other day when he said, "What about your guy you put in charge of picking the vice president, or helping you pick him?" Saying that's not really a job. He's not really that important. It's a discrete task.
Wait,
I love that phrase. A discrete task.
So this is all setting us up for something that's going to be a pretty big story soon, which is public financing. So Barack Obama is setting himself up as a saintly figure, morally pure. How, given that, is he going to say, "No, I'm going to go back on my pledge"? Should take public money. I'm going to have it privately financed. How can he do that?
Okay, the wonderful thing about Barack Obama that has inspired me, I'll admit it, I've admitted it before, is the absolute freshness of the guy coming from an interracial background, coming with this fascinating sort of third world background, being raised partially in Indonesia and then, of course, in Hawaii with interesting background in Chicago, an Ivy League education on top of everything, Harvard Law, all this wonderful magic of life, and yet there's a certain mundane quality to this campaign setting in. The tit for tat over taxes the other day could have been between Walter Mondale and Ronald Reagan or between Adlai Stevenson and Dick Nixon. This is an old fight. Democrats tax, Republicans don't tax. Republicans do other things that are wrong. This isn't seeming like a brand new kind of election right now.
It's not. The only thing that is
brand new. I
mean,
arguing over personnel
is the Democratic nominee and the Republican nominee. But I am certain that between now and November, it will get more interesting again.
I want novelty. I want phenomenon. And today we're talking about personnel in the vice presidential selection process. By the way, wasn't Dick Cheney the guy in charge of picking the vice president for Georgia?
He was.
And who did he pick?
So Jim Johnson could have been the VP.
I always thought, you know, everybody doesn't think Dick Cheney knows how to get the job done, doesn't pay
It'll
attention.
It'll be Caroline Kennedy.
He was the guy in charge of picking the VP, and somehow, I could just see him going, here's Dick Cheney. You know, George, Governor, if you don't mind me calling you George, you know, it's too bad about Tom Ridge being pro-choice and not sharing our values.